It's been a very long time that I haven't created video related to CSS animation. In this video, I'm going to create CSS 3D animation. As you can see, Earth is rotating and that rotation is kind of 3D rotation. In order to give that extra feel of 3D effect, I'm adding that shadow for the Earth. Just wait, let's take it further. I'm adding that satellite, and that satellite is revolving around the Earth, which is also adding an extra 3D feel. Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone, this is Jitsaru with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. I'm in VS Code and I have already created index.html file. Inside the index.html file, if I type exclamation sign and hit that tab button, then you'll get this basic HTML code. Now for the title, I'm giving animated 3D glow, and also let's give CSS 3D animation. Inside the body tag, I'm creating section with class name planet, and inside that section, let's create div with class name earth, and inside that div, I'm creating another div with class name shadow. Now just below the title tag, let's give the link for our style.css file. But I haven't created that style.css file, so now let's create that style.css file. Now with the help of Live Server extension, let's open this index.html file in our default browser and let's adjust this screens. In the style.css file for the inversion selector, in order to prevent the browser's default margin and padding, for the margin and padding I'm giving 0 and also box sizing to border box. For the body, let's give the background color, I'm giving this dark gray color. Now let's style this section with class name planet and div with class name earth. For the class planet, I'm giving minimum height of 100 VH. And for the class earth, let's give the width and height of 22 rem. And I'm giving background image. For the background image, I'm giving radial gradient. For the first color, let's give cyan. And for the second color, let's give navy, okay? And also, in order to get that circle shape, I'm giving border radius of 50%. Now for the class earth and for the class planet, I want to give the same CSS property, okay? So these two classes, they are sharing this property, display grid, and place items to center. Now you can see that sphere is brought exactly at the center of your browser. Now for the class earth, I want to give the box shadow. For the x and y offset, I'm giving 0. And for the blur value, I'm giving 0.3 rem. And for the color, let's give black color with some transparent value. As you can see, inside the div with class name earth, I have given there another div with class name shadow. So now for the class shadow, let's give position of absolute. Let's duplicate this code and let's take it to that class earth. For the class earth, let's give position of relative. For the class shadow, let's give width of 20 rem. For the height, I'm giving 2 rem. And for the background color, let's give black color with some transparent value. And also let's give border radius of 50%. And let's make it blurry. So for that, I'm writing filter blur. I'm giving 10 pixel. And now let's take it to the downside. So for that, I'm giving bottom minus 22%. This is exactly what I want. Now for the class earth, I am giving before shadow element. So with the help of this before shadow element, I want to give some background image. And for the class shadow, I want to give this same property, okay? So let's give comma and let's paste this code. And I am giving content empty string. Okay, this code shouldn't be here. For the class earth with before shadow element, okay, that content property should be here. For the before pseudo element, you have to get content property, otherwise you won't be able to create that before pseudo element. And I'm giving width and height of 25 rem. And I'm using the background shorthand property. Let's give the URL. As you can see, in the same folder, I do have folder named images. And inside that folder, I do have two images, map.png and satellite.png. So in the URL function, let's give images slash map.png, okay? For the background position, I'm giving 1280 pixel. For the x, and for the y-axis I'm giving minus 40 pixel. For the x position I'm giving there 1280 pixel, because if you look at the dimension of the map, that png image, its dimension is 1280 by 720 pixel. So that 1280, that value is the same value of that image dimension. Okay, and if I give slash, then I can give the background size. For the background size x and y I'm giving 100%, and for the background repeat I'm giving repeat x. So I have to give the repeat x because when you are rotating that image map, I want that image to repeat in x-axis. Okay, I want to add some drop shadow for that image, so for that I'm giving filter drop shadow. For the x and y offset I'm giving 0.5 rem, and for the blur value let's give 0.2 rem, and for the color I'm giving black color with some transparent value. After adding that drop shadow, we did add some kind of 3d effect. Okay, now it's looking more 3d as you can see. Now it's time to give the animation. So we are rotating that map image. Okay, so I'm giving animation name rotate earth. For the animation duration I'm giving 14 seconds. For the timing function let's give linear, and now let's create the keyframes. At keyframes let's give the same animation name rotate earth, and for the keyframe I'm giving at 50%. As you can see, at the initial state we have already given the background size as well as the background position this value. Okay, so now let's give at 50%. I'm giving background position for x-axis let's give 0 pixel. For the y-axis I'm giving 40 pixel, and also let's give background size. For the background size for x and y I'm giving 120%. As you can see, that animation it's taking place. Okay, now let's select this code and let's duplicate it. Now instead of that 50% let's give 100%, and at 100% for the background position for the x I'm giving 1120 pixel, and for the y axis we'll give the same minus 40 pixel, and also for the background size we'll give the same 100%. Okay, so let's copy this code and let's paste it there. Now in the browser you can see that cool animation. But after 14 seconds that animation it stops. So let's give animation iteration count to infinite. So now that animation will animate forever. But I'm not satisfied with this animation. Okay, it is good but it is not that great. So now let's take it further. Okay, inside the div with class name earth let's create image with class name satellite, and for the image source I'm giving images slash that satellite.png image. Now for the class satellite let's give the position of absolute. For the width I'm giving 10 rem, and also let's take it to the left side. So I'm giving left minus 60%. Let's take it to the full screen by pressing F11 key. As you can see that satellite is at the left side, and also let's take it to the bottom. So I'm giving top 60%. So now that satellite is at the bottom side. Now let's give the animation. Now what I want to do is that I want to give the animation something like that satellite should revolve around that earth. Okay, so for that I'm giving animation name of rotate satellite. For the duration I'm giving 10 seconds. For the timing function let's give is in out, and also let's give the iteration count to infinite. It's time to give the keyframes for this animation. So at keyframes let's copy the same animation name and paste it there. Now at 49% let's give the top value of minus 10%, and in the browser now you can see this kind of animation. Now I want to animate this satellite to the left side as well. So for that at 50% let's give the left value to 110%. As you can see, initially for the left I have given there minus 60%. Now in the browser you can see that satellite is moving towards left as well as the right. But I want to give something like when that satellite reaches to that 99% I want to hide that satellite, and when it again at 0% I wanna display it again. Okay, so for that at 99% if I give the g-index of minus 100, with the help of that g-index minus 100 I can take that satellite to backside of that earth. Now you can see this kind of effect, it's like satellite is revolving around the earth. I know this is not enough, it could be better. You can give something like instead of that gray background color you could give multiple stars, and also you can add some extra elements, something like you could give moon that would revolve around the earth, and there are so many things you could do much more better than this. Okay, I will leave it to you. So what do you say, did you love this animation? If you love it, please let me know in the comment box. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it, and also if you haven't already yet, hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn, so keep learning.